decision to make. It's only the 17th of January and I already broke one of my New Year's resolutions. I caved. I'm weak, I have no willpower, and I'm fine with it. I bought five new books, even though I promised myself I wasn't going to buy any more books until I'd started to make a dent in the list and the pile of the ones I already have. But I was out shopping.
In the supermarket or a bookshop before I actually pick it up and buy it, but this is the first time I've seen these three books. So I just grabbed them. I couldn't stop myself. And whilst I was there, I saw this one and I thought, you know what? I'm in the mood for a little bit of dystopian fiction. So I just got it. And then this one hiding over in the corner. Well, I just had to see what all the fuss was about, really. With all of that being said, let me just show you the books. So the first book is called My Extraordinary Life, and it's by an author called Rebecca Ryan. I've never heard of Rebecca Ryan before. So, I think this potentially is her first book. Let's begin. Have you ever wondered how normal you are? What if you were human? She sees her life, her job, her hair, her favorite food, all of her plainly horrifically average, even her blood group. Right then and there, she decides she wants more. She'll travel the world, i.e. venture out of her hometown. She'll become a vegan. It's interesting to hate cheese, right? She'll do something daring, as long as it's safety tested. Nothing will stand in the way of Emily living her best life. Not even Josh and his dimples. Because she absolutely cannot fall in love. That would be far too ordinary. And from now on, Emily is going to be extraordinary.
So, I like the sound of this. Let's give it a go and see what we think. Now, Jane Fallon, I have heard of, definitely read books by her before. And this one is called Just Got Real.
friends and via a dating app. Neither is entirely honest about who they are, but when they meet in real life, they fall for each other. Soon they are a happy, steady item, until Johnny discovers Ant is still on the app, still dating other women. Having secret rivals devastates Johnny, so she decides to take revenge, but not on them. Can she turn these rivals into allies to get back at the real enemy, Ant? Now, Adele Parks, who I really, really love as an author, says Jane just keeps getting better and better. So smart, funny, and warm. So, I really, really did not need to buy these books. I didn't, truly, but books are my happy place, so I can't even feel too bad about it. This next one is called The Ark, and this is by successful, witty, smart, and single. She's tried all the dating apps and she's underwhelmed by her options. Enter The Ark, a mysterious, super sophisticated matchmaking service that relies on a complex series of emotional, psychological, and physiological assessments. The price tag is high. The promise, ambitious. You get one match, and one match only, because one is all you need for a partnership that will go the distance. Ursula is matched with Raphael and immediately feels the electric, lasting love she's been seeking. But the arc of a relationship is never predictable, even when it's fully optimized. She would must be retrained, that bad mothers everywhere must be re-educated, while their mistakes cost them everything. The School for Good Mothers is an explosive and thrilling novel about love, perfectionism, and parenthood. And this is The Handmaid's Tale for the Squid Game Generation. A remarkable, propulsive novel.
Examination.